And guys, this is Kenya's last best chance. And our children, our great grandchildren and our grandchildren will blame us. We are so close, guys. And we have this guy cornered. You've seen his body language. Today he's conceding, tomorrow he's threatening. So tushampata. And we are so close. Tumepewa pena, bro. Tuko 1-1. Alafu tukapewa pena at the 90th minute. Na lazima tufunge, bro. Brothers and sisters. So as a person who has traveled this journey for quite a long time, a person who has endured so much, who has suffered so much, alafu kufika kwa hapa kwa finishing line, alafu tuna stop, yani atupiti your line, tunaanza kuwa disorganized. We need to understand that this thing is not just about Kenya. People have called me from Uganda, they're going to parliament on Tuesday. They are looking upon us. Tanzania, Uganda, Africa is looking upon us. The whole world is discussing Kenya. CNN is here day in, day out. We are about, we are at the verge of making history and changing Kenya forever. We cannot lose this fight, especially now. If these people reorganize, re-strategize, and regroup, we will regret it. Tutalia kwa chuo. Yeah? And guys, we need to be very clear at this 11th hour. What do we want? What are we going for? And after we've achieved it, how do we move forward? Tunasema Ruto must go. If Ruto goes tomorrow, Gashagwa takes over. We must start changing our narrative and our demands. It is the presidency. It is the presidency must go. Wacha Wetangula take over for 90 days, sijui ni 60, and then we constitute. And that's why I was very happy when Ruto started the process of constituting the IEBC. So we must, tusijipige own goal. Ruto sitoka na Gashagwa ingie, it could be worse. So first of all, we cannot be disorganized. We cannot be fighting amongst ourselves. And I have the moral authority to say what I'm saying, because I and I think on this platform I can say it. Maybe I can say it on the traditional media. Some of us started this thing, and the vision we had, the dream we had, the prayer we had, all of a sudden, to say ni Mungu, it's happening. And some of us, it pains us to see that tumekimbia tukafika pale maze badala tupitishe tu line tumalize kazi. We've run a good we've kept the faith. Alafu sasa tunaingiliwa na infiltration and na mavita. So what are we looking for? Whether Ruto resigns or he doesn't resign, I hope he does, we must know what we want. Kuna kitu tumeanzisha. Paka juzi kumekuwa na earthquake. I don't want to get spiritual on this platform. Do you know the last time Kenya had an earthquake? There's a lot that is going on in this country. Things are shifting. Paka plectonic plates. To make a point, it's like a pregnant woman in labor. Nothing can stop this from coming forth. Mtoto atazaliwa. And it has nothing to do with Ruto. Ruto ataenda ata kesho. But there are things that I will tell you guys today that we must achieve. First of all, this bullshit of county government, of devolution. Devolution was meant to devolve services. It only devolved corruption. Why do we have 47 counties? America is a continent. The country of America is the size of a continent. They have 50 governors. Why do we have 47 governors and 47 senators? What are the work? Kazi ya women rep ni nini? Why do we nominate MCAs and MPs and senators? Immediately we achieve, because we shall achieve. We must revert back to 8 counties. Nimona leo kufini governor yupi. You know what's going on with Wamatangi. You know what's going on with the governor Alinini. Alinunua kreti moja saw that 1 million. Kuna mwingine amefungua bridge. A very small bridge. Hata kuna maji. Just on a flat surface. I don't know if you saw the bridge. We must do away with the 37. Do you know how big Texas is? The state of Texas. Na nilisema juzi mtu wananipinga. Kenya goes into Texas 2 times. And it is led by one governor effectively. Texas is the size of Kenya 2x. Once we achieve whatever we achieve, to end a referendum, we are fixing the nation from the root problem, which is corruption, nepotism, tribalism, and partyism. Hizi pesa zinapotea kwa county. Zinapotea na Sakaja na our governors. We must revert back to 8 provinces. Let us visit the counties. Well, let us have the coastal county, the western Muite Mulembe County, Muite Pwani County, Muite Nyanza County. Well, Kenya is too small to have 47 governors. Alafu wakuna kazi wanafanya, mmesikia what my sister just said there. That is our target. Our number one target is to get rid of the presidency. Constitutionally, Ruto akitoka leo, Gachagua anaingia. Tunarudi kutena kwa demonstrations, kukufa tena. We are doing away with the presidency. Wacha Wetangula chukue, legally atachukua for how long? In 90 days. We must go into election. The MPs who voted yes must all go, must all be recalled. So tukue na targets. Target number one, we gave President Ruto an opportunity. I personally was very happy when the president dissolved the cabinet and expected him to self-preserve. I expected him to listen to the people. Ruto had an opportunity to do what the people wanted without any of his cronies castigating him or attacking him. He had the opportunity to tell them what say ni wa Kenya na umona wamegia paka parliament. So I expected him doozy when the president anaongea. I expected to come and fire all the parastatal heads and then fire all the PSS and then fire every government official. He lost his chance. He lost his only chance. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Kenya's best last option. And it will not come around again. It will not come around for another 100 years. And Uganda is looking up to us. Africa is looking up to us. Because revolution revival starts from Nairobi. So the bullcrap of Cairo said, Bonnie did, and you who did it, it pains my heart. And if there are people who are infiltrating and you've been paid, may God strike you with lightning. May the blood of Kenyans who died, whose brains were blown off, may that blood go straight to your family and your great-great-grandchildren. May that curse fall upon your head. Guys, I will repeat again. Politics is an act of a few organized people controlling a majority that is disorganized. Mimi nimesikwa 13 times. I've been on the street for 2 years. Nikitwa cloud chaser, joker, comedian, But finally, I wake up and I see it's happening. Guys, tumepewa pena. Hata goalkeeper ametolewa. Tukihata, tumehata. And I know Ruto's people are on this, they're on this platform. Listen and listen to me carefully. You guys had an opportunity. And President Ruto still, junajua mko hapa ndani. You had an opportunity. You still have an opportunity. Tell President Ruto to fire his cabinet again tomorrow. Asingoje Tuesday. Fire all PSs. Fire all parastatal heads. Fire every single government official. And then maybe, perhaps maybe, that is the only way. Now, if the president attempts to do anything that we've had or seen before, akileta dialogue, alete committee, alete all platforms, the president knows what people are calling for. And this is not even about Ruto. This is about injustices that have existed since 1963. And Ruto is the last of his generation. The best he can do is try to forge a legacy. We have given him that opportunity. Fire your government. And the least you can do is call for, allow us to recall these MPs. Na wewe tutakutana wewe 2027. Venye unasemanga. Ama, call for elections. But in direction ya kutreten, there are 53 million Kenyans. And we must realize this. Against less than 2,000 government officials. From president to MC, our fiki yata 2,000. Wakienda sana 2,500. Against 53 million. Guys, this is Kenya's last best chance. And it will not come around again. It will not come around again. Let's take an opportunity. It is a God-given opportunity. It is a God-given opportunity. Na tutalia kwa chuo. Watasemanga, now they'll talk about that in the other countries and in history books. There was a time Kenyans almost changed the course of history. And I will repeat as I finish, what are we aiming at? Tukisha achieve, county government must go. Women reps must go. What is the work of 47 women reps who are earning from taxpayers' money if within the 2024 finance bill there was a clause taxing sanitary pads that was only discovered by Gen Zs and men, not even women? These 47 women could not come together and fight and rally. Kazi yao, they must go. Kazi ya women reps ni nini? Na hata OMCAs. Hata OMCAs. Even these MCAs, they will one day very soon explain to us, kazi yao ni nini? Kazi yao ni nini? Nothing has been done with, since devolution. Only corruption and nepotism and tribalism. Hakuna kitu mefanyika. Turudi kwa provinces zetu na tuziite county. Tukue na governors wa nani. And every person who will get into a government office beginning now must take a pay cut. Because I'm assuming those are not people we know. We are giving them an opportunity. Tunakupea opportunity atukujui. You are fresh, whether you are Gen Z. I'm away in a millennium. We are starting afresh. You will take a pay. Utachukua mshahara tumekupea. Will not be unfair. Haitakuwa very high, haitakuwa very low. We are starting afresh and we are fixing the nation. Guys, our root cause are vitu kama hizo nimewaambia. Women reps, I'm very disappointed. I've been following very keenly. I know who blew the whistle on the pads. It was not a woman. It was not even a woman rep. The nominated, the nyamus of this world, wanafanya kazi gani? They are not accountable. Afadhali hao wengine wameelektiwa, wanaogopanga juu wanaona watarudi. Kura itaenda. Huyu mwingine ako nominated, ana serve nani? Constituencies wake ni nani? Ako accountable to nani? Hizo ni vitu za Moi. And finally, as I finish, kuna wakina Jomo Kenyatta, Oginga Odinga, Ochenga Neko, Bildad Kagia, we know them. The first generation, they fought for this nation. And they gave us freedom from the white man. We are the second liberators. So you know what the liberators? Hawa kina Martha Karua. Tunawajua, hawa lipigania. Kina multipartism. We must recognize that another one is happening now. Wakina Kenyatta waliachieve. Hawa kina Martha Karua, walikuwa na kina Omingo Magara, sijui akina Orengo, they achieved. Multipartism. We must realize hii nyingine inafanyika, it is the last liberation of a nation. We celebrate Kenyatta and whoever he was with because of whatever they did. So guys, this is our last best chance. And it is not a Kenyan thing. This is an East African thing, it's an African thing. Asante ni sana, ndugu zangu.
Okay, thank you so much, Eric Omondi, for that submission. Masitarus.
Thank you so much. I want to remind all of us that when we started all of this, we said we were leaderless, tribeless, partyless, fearless. And we are actually tribeless. You see, tribalism wants to derail the movement. Tribalism wants you to protect someone that does not want to protect you. Every time you hear our president, I want to put this across very clearly, that when the president is elected, he is the president of Kenya, not a governor of a county in Rift Valley. So there's nothing like our president and the president of Rift Valley. He is at work to serve Kenyans